Vita, Nandatia Kun Tichadai, Tungpa Tungas Maktelea. Jedaba the one and Nidibobo, Tong Nabungsha Nununya, Tong Patukashmak Telea.
I trust this information is important enough for you to disturb me from my meditation.
Takum Justach Miki Grabblebogo, Kachichu Ita Bodunga, Tolbabank, Waleoganda Naru Chuchut, Mogesha Ponka, Bola Wana Chikne.
If the Republic is truly building an attack force outside their own territories, then they are either extremely cunning or extremely foolish.
Runda di hotonga kun hunkabi. Wana kun bez ching palamule tunking ba nunotek.
You will not destroy our enemies so hastily, Admiral. Give them time to breathe. The Republic has some hidden agenda here, and I'm curious to find out what it is. Send the message for all fleets within this sector to join with the Outer Rim fleet and await my command.
Yikukuno no ba mulira tikun.
I sense something is on your mind, Admiral.
Achuta, wonga kun bis dolpi kikuyana.
I have little time for games, Admiral. Speak your mind or leave.
Ra tikun. Tong hit kun chunching, ne boboje mata de punage, dulpi kikuana.
Tilos, what business do you have there?
We itanan dayata. What a yuma wama huhu nandetik. Shatung ni patoga. Ki puna! Kavadumpa ku palea muka bata! Tune pudu! Ranunu prata dongo shirkaja! Tum apike!
Have you forgotten that we are at war, Admiral? Tilos' destruction was vital to my plans.
Jedabadwana nidibobo. Tong nabungsha nununya.
But I am not completely unsympathetic to your plight, however. You may take a small leave of absence after this operation.
Ucha dunga ya fulke! Chachiska da punta kasa pupaka!
Ton chun chun ke nemolek rabest wuf mala nebo kurk.
Put him through.
Inform Lord Malak we have the rats, but let us deploy some fighters in case our friends feel like going anywhere.
Very good, sir.
What's happening?
Sith interdictor ship!
Oh great, they're charging up the tractor beam. We've got company. Tell me some good news.
Statement. The Sith warship is blocking our designated hyperspace path, Master.
So, let's turn this piece of junk around.
Correction. No, Master. Several Sith fighters have been deployed. We have no choice but to engage them.
Are you mad?
My plan is not suicidal, you bucket of bolts.
Right, Candorus, man the turrets. Keep an eye on those fighters.
Right.
Statement. The tin can can plot us a new hyperspace route, Master. But we will need several moments.
Oh, sure. I bet the Sith would love a good chat.
I would much rather this get bloody, Master, but it is your call.
It's a communication, sir, from the vessel.
This should be amusing. Patch them through.
This is Commander Brax Drevet of the Sith Empire.
You all get silly names like that, or are you just Malak's special pal?
Charming to the last. Surrender now, and we won't have to bring you aboard by force.
Oh, sure. Why don't you come aboard? I think I've got some Tyrizian ale stored somewhere. We could crack open a bottle.
Really? You could at least have offered Cassandran brandy.
Oh, sorry. That's a bit pricey for me.
I don't get a paycheck from the Sith.
I know what you were trying to do, Jedi. It won't work. Any moment now, you won't be going anywhere.
I'm sorry. I'm having trouble hearing you.
I don't speak Shudder.
This communication is over. I will see you very shortly.
No, you won't. T3. Punch it.
Activate the tractor beam.
Sir, Lord Malak's apprentice wishes to speak to you.
I see. Bandon. We nearly had them. They slipped between our fingers.
Commander Drevet, my disappointment in you cannot be overstated.
Release me, damn you!
First you failed to capture Bastila Shan, now you do the same again.
But they haven't escaped!
Explain.
We analyzed their navigational systems. They were headed to the Kashyyyk system, to Kashyyyk itself.
You had best be right. For your sake.
I am always right.
Prepare my shuttle. I will tend to this alone.
Still, that could have gone worse, sir. Not many survived these encounters with Bandon.
You're new here, aren't you?
Yes, sir. My first deployment.
Pity.
Sir?
I will not be condescended to by some low-level officer on my own ship.
Ready to go, Big Z? Wait, bad terms? How come? You sure, Big Z? Planet of the Walking Carpets. Dian, I thought this was Kashyyyk.
Kolodus, the vulnerable. Usta gel, please. Undasta shelfa. Shea, vulnerable reason. Usta the underbot.
I'm sure the Wookiees love that.
Usta dan gelfa. Oisi dan gelfa. Uri tusla vulnerable gelfa. Where Pundas. Usta gel, please.
You're kidding. 100 credits for this?
When now for the Dufta. She endured it out. And ready good.
It's daylight robbery. Fine. Take it.
Kolo Dufta. Kolo Dufta. Ivan Rebu. Kora. Uri Dufta.
Can you believe that guy? Well, I'm at a loss here, guys. Bastila?
Kashyyyk is a lush but simple and undeveloped world. I would not have expected to find the alien technology of a star map here. The Wookiees of Kashyyyk make their home high among the Rosha branches. Only their bravest warriors dare to descend into the forbidding depths of the forest. If the star map is located far beneath us on the planet's surface, it's unlikely the Wookiees even know of its existence.
No sense waiting around here, though.
Well, it's probably our best chance. Let's go meet some Wookiees.
Zalbar should be here. He shouldn't miss this. He needs to know he can come back here.
He wanted to stay on the ship mission.
I can't talk for Big Z, but believe me, he should be with us. He's got unfinished business here.
Look, I'm just respecting his wishes.
He looked like there was something he needed to do. Besides, we don't know this planet. He could prove useful.
Perhaps you should reconsider leaving Zalbar behind. This is, after all, his homeworld. We know very little of this planet.
It has big trees, in case your eyes don't work anymore.
My eyes are optimized for long-range scanning, Master.
Yeah, that's wonderful, HK.
Good or bad, he's got to have some interest in Kashyyyk. I'd rather have him with us.
Look, guys, he doesn't want to be here, all right? Let's just get this over with. Mission.
Is this about power, then? You would rather make a decision for the sake of making it than make it wisely?
How can you even say that? Now come on, we should split up to cover more ground.
The Jedi are here. Stay alert and attack without mercy.
Yes, Lord Bandon.
If that gate guard was right, then the Wookiee village should be just up ahead. Do you guys hear that? It's too quiet. Oh, great.
Lord Malak was most displeased when he learned you had escaped Terrace alive. He has promised a great reward to whoever destroys you.
Yeah, the last guy said the same.
Purge the trash. Keep Bastila alive for Lord Malak.
Why does Malak want Bastila? Tell me!
You may have bested me, but when you least expect it, the last thing you will sense is one of us behind you. One of us will...
Sorry, you were saying... Sith spit. What is it with this place and sneaking up on people? Hi. My name's Dann Kasra. My associate. Zalbar, you went on my ship.
Mm-hmm.
Big Z, are you alright? Your thugs raided my ship without my permission. Don't start making demands to me now. So it's true, you're working with the slavers. You don't really believe yourself, do you? The truth about your involvement with Zerga will come out. Just try it. You might find me a bit more of a challenge to get through than your mindless followers. Please, just let Zawar go. I won't ask again. No, I'm not going to let them do this to you, Big Z. What do you want? It's okay, Zalba. Alright, fine. I'll do it. I can't wait. The star map is down there. Alright, look, I don't like it, guys, but I can't help Big Z without it. Plus, the star map is down there. It's our only lead. Tell the others to come here. I'll go down alone.
Then I suppose we have little choice. We should proceed with caution, however.
That's reassuring. Nice moves.
Ah, the damnable racket of battle. Watch yourself. Even more of these crawling beasts are hiding in the underbrush.
Don't worry about that. I think you got them.
Not this again! Well, welcome to my home, such as it is. Pull up a stump and be comfortable. We should discuss a few things.
Nice, place you got here.
Yeah, I live like some burrowing rodent. I fought the Sith. Now look at me.
Wait, what? Who are you?
I'm Jolie. Jolie Bindo.
You're a Jedi.
Don't start fawning just yet. I'm too old for it. I know a few things.
Oh, sure, Master Jedi.
Don't coddle me, child. I'm neither a Jedi nor your master. I'm just an old man that's been lost in the woods for far too long.
But you said you fought the Sith. You are a Jedi. Why have you exiled yourself down here?
Why? Don't you like what I've done with the place? The creatures here aren't any more treacherous than elsewhere.
I can't sense the dark side within you.
Well, I assure you, I see more gray than dark or light. I'm just a stubborn old man, tired of the foolishness of others.
Well, thanks for patching me up, but with all due respect, I really don't have time for this.
Whoa, ho, ho! Your manner is fearsome!
Are you going to help me, or should I leave?
Fine, fine, just be brief.
Ever heard of star maps? I'm looking for one buried down here.
Now why would you be asking about that, Don't answer. I knew that had to be why you were here. The Wookiees have their legends that they were not always here. But it is more than that. The trees themselves are strangers.
Oh, come on. I don't have time for superstitious legend.
What I'm saying is that there are literally walls in your way. And you won't find what you need without my help. And my help has a price.
Here we go.
You presumably have a ship. I've seen all I wish to here. Isn't that enough? I mean, I'm really sick of the trees.
Well, the Hawk's getting a little cramped, but fine. Welcome aboard, I guess.
Well, hurry up. You don't want to be stuck here as long as I have. There, you see? Beautifully subtle, isn't it? At least compared to the other Zerka equipment dumped down here. It's only been here a short while, or the Wookiees would have disabled it. They wouldn't have had an easy time of it, though.
Why would Zerka put up a force field in a tree?
Well, there are others, each blocking similar points on certain paths. It is all very calculated, very precise. It would have been effective if it hadn't relied on the creatures to be walking. Climbers don't have much trouble getting around it.
I take it you can get past it?
I can manipulate it for a moment. Let me see. How did the Zerka engineers do it? There we go. Now, keep moving. These are the most dangerous depths of Kashyyyk. A few surprises wait for us, I'll wager.
There it is. Oh, this is not good.
Yes, of course.
It should be working.
Life forms detected. Determining parameters. Initiating neural recognition.
Yes, there's the thing. Obstinate machine. I've no doubt it holds what you seek, but good luck getting it operational.
Primary neural recognition complete. Preliminary match found.
Match found? What the... It always muttered something about rejected patterns for me.
Begin socialized interface. Awaiting instruction. Greetings. This terminal has not been accessed for quite some time.
What are you exactly?
Subject displays unfamiliarity to environment. Behavioral reconfiguration will be needed before access. I am sorry. I did not mean to confuse you. I will answer questions to the best of my programming limitations.
Right. I need access to the star map.
Accessing? Yes, I have found a star map in original system memory. Access is restricted.
Of course. All right. How do I gain access to it?
Your request requires additional security access. You must be made to match the parameters I have been supplied.
And if I fail these parameters?
Then you are not worthy of further access. You will be rejected as unsuitable.
No pressure then. Begin the test.
Evaluation commencing. Result will be compared against the pattern in memory. Just act like you should. You travel with a Wookiee and have encountered complications. Hypothetical. You and this Zalbar are captured and separated. If you both remain silent, 1 year in prison for each of you. However, call Zalbar a traitor, and he will serve 5 years, while you serve none. He is offered the same deal. But if you both accuse the other, you both serve 2 years. What do you do? What do you trust him to do?
I trust Bigsy. I wouldn't do anything to betray him.
Are you sure? If you turn, you risk 2 years. Or none at all.
But that's what I do.
Your loyalty is dangerous. Your companion could take the opportunity to benefit by turning on you.
This machine certainly seems to want a very specific type of response.
But I'm being honest. I wouldn't turn on my friends.
Error. Zalbar's family is mired in treachery. What loyalty do they know? Your answer is incorrect.
Damn it. Okay, I guess I would accuse him. I wouldn't trust him to stay silent.
The temperament of a companion is unreliable at best. You wisely trade the threat of 1 year or five for none or two. I judge the answer correct. You display the proper behavior to match the pattern in memory.
So, what now?
You have matched the pattern in memory. I recognize you and will fulfill my designated function.
All right, give me access to the star map.
Yes, you are ready. Soon you will recognize the proper course to follow. The star map is yours. This unit has now completed its primary duty and has finished with the subject. Executing final action. Activation of star map commencing. Parameters reset. Stasis initiated. End communication.
Three down, two to go.
Well, well, a star map. An ancient artifact of dark side power. Can't say I'm surprised. I always knew there was something funny down here. I wonder if the star map has had an effect on the evolution of the creatures here in the Shadowlands. Might explain why it's so dangerous down here.
Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me. We found a star map on Tatooine that corrupted the mind of a crate dragon. Maybe it's done the same to the native animals here.
An interesting theory, but I suppose we don't have time to test it now, do we?
You're right. We need to go find that exiled Wookiee and get out of here.
I won't ask you again, animal. Where has the Jedi gone? You're testing me, Wookiee.
He's almost feral after all this time.
Great. Let's go say hello.
Calm yourself, Freya. We are friends. Don't you remember me? Well, this may prove difficult.
Freya, wait. We've been sent here by the Wookiees, by Zalbar and Chunda. Yes, Big Z, Zalbar, he's a friend of mine. As for Chunda, well, he wanted me to come down here and kill you, but I'm not going to do that. Have I said something to offend you? Oh.
That's when I first saw him. I helped his pursuers lose him for a moment.
And now he's sent me down here to do his dirty work. Damn. He's okay. Chundar took him prisoner, has leveraged me to come down here. Zalbar followed me to Kashyyyk because he swore a life debt to me. Trust me, I wish I knew. Well, I'm not going to let Chundar get away with this. My name's Dann Kasra. Will you help me? But it's worth a try. I am not killing you, and Chundar is not getting away with this. We're Jedi, and I cannot let this happen. You're being a coward, Freya. Yeah, I get it. You messed up, big time. You let yourself be manipulated, and now you feel guilty for what happened to Zalbar. Well, that isn't my concern. I'm going up there now to free my friend and all the other Wookiees Chundar and Zerka have enslaved, but I'm telling them the truth, Freya. I'm telling them you didn't have the guts to fight for your family. Let's get going. He's dead. His neck's been snapped. No wild beast did this. Come on, we need to get out of here. I didn't expect to see you again. You willing to fight? How did you even get up here? We took the lift. Right. They don't look too happy to see us. Zalbar, you're a monster. What have you done to him? This is over, Chundar, and I'm running out of patience. Let Zalbar and the other Wookiees go and walk away from this. He will, Big Z. Don't worry. This is your last chance, Chunda. Don't you realize what you're doing? You're tearing your family apart. Stop this now, Chundar. The village is yours, Freya. I hope that you... I'm so sorry, I didn't see him. You have my word. No harm will come to him. Monster, why would you do that? He killed your father. He's no brother of yours.
There is no emotion.
There is peace. The only reason I'm letting you live is because I'm respecting your father's wishes, and Zalbar's. As of now, the Zerka occupation of Kashyyyk is over. There will be no more slaves here or anywhere else. And if you ever come back, rest assured, I'll know, and you'll regret ever being born. Make this tribe something to be proud of, in the memory of Freya. The Wookiees of Kashyyyk are free. You can stay if you want. I wouldn't blame you. You have a home again. Something I don't have. Zalbar, your eye. I should have been quicker. I should never even left you here to begin with. I failed. And you got hurt because of it. I'm not gonna let this happen again. To any of you. I'm so sorry about your father. He was an honorable Wookiee. That's great, Bigsy. I'll get you back safely. I promise. Yeah, I'm okay. I just got a lot on my mind. Is Mission okay? She seemed pretty shocked with me. There was a moment where I wanted to kill your brother, Zalbar. And I didn't like it. There was something inside me that wanted to kill him. And I feel like he deserved it, but... it's not who I am. As a Jedi, I can't. And it frightened me that I wanted to do that. Neither do I. The last of the Wookiees have been liberated, and Zerka's been sent packing. Something's on your mind, Bastila. I can tell. What is it?
You must prepare yourself for when we face Malak. The confrontation will be difficult for you. I remember how hard it was when I first faced Revan.
So it's true. You really did kill Darth Revan.
It's true that due to my battle meditation, I was with the Jedi strike team that boarded Revan's ship. We did not kill Revan, however.
But who killed him, then?
Our mission was to capture Revan, if possible. You cannot win, Revan. It was Malak who turned on his own master, firing upon Revan's ship while we were still on board it. It was his desire to kill us and his master both. Thankfully, we narrowly escaped the vessel as it exploded.
But you would have killed Revan eventually, right?
As I said, we were there to capture Revan alive. The Jedi do not believe in killing their prisoners. No one deserves execution, no matter what their crimes.
Seems foolish to me. How could you risk letting someone so evil live?
Remember that Revan and Malak were once great Jedi, heroes in every sense of the word. They demonstrate the danger of the dark side to us all.
Yeah, you're telling me.
I'm sorry, we really shouldn't speak of this anymore. The memory of my confrontation with Revan is painful. Let's return to the mission, please.
So you're the Jedi my master has sent me after.
Sorry, didn't catch your name.
I am Darth Bandon, sole apprentice to Lord Malak. I've been looking forward to meeting you for some time.
Just so you know, I've got a ship full of Jedi. Make the move and we'll take you down.
Oh, I am not going to attack you yet. This is just a warning.
A warning?
Just a little heads up. I wanted you to know I'm coming for you, so when I finally catch you, it'll be fair.
That's oddly considerate for a Sith.
Huh, we're not all savages. Think of it as fair sport. I'm giving you a head start. Run fast, Dann Kasra. I'm coming for you. Master!
I trust you are not wasting my time.
The Jedi were here, my lord. On Kashyyyk. I have placed a tracking device on their vessel and will follow them and kill Bastila and her friends.
Her companions are nothing to me, but I desire the young Jedi taken alive, if at all possible.
Master, is it wise to spare them? I could strike them down so easily.
Your predecessor once made the mistake of questioning my orders. Surely you are not so foolish as to make the same mistake.
No. No, my master. I will bring her to you.
You are dismissed, apprentice.
I've been trying to come up with the best way to say this for some time, but I suppose I should just come out and say it. The truth is, I have come to depend on you, not just for the sake of the mission, but for my own sake as well. I'm glad you're with us.
Hold on, say that again. I think I must be going deaf.
You're teasing me. You know very well what I said.
I'm just still reeling from the shock. Was that a compliment?
Well, yes. Surely that's not so surprising.
Are you kidding?
No, I'm not. Why must you make this so difficult for me? Can't you just accept a simple compliment?
No, I just didn't expect it from you.
I see. Is there nothing I can do to make it up to you? I would rather we were friends.
Friends? Are you sure that's all that's going on here?
You know I can't feel that way about you. About any man, it isn't permitted. I'm a Jedi. I must resist these temptations. But I still want to consider you a friend. We could never be anything more, though. That isn't allowed.
I just... Yeah. Yeah, I'd like that, I suppose.
I know my manner can be a bit taciturn. I know you must be getting sick of my lectures about the dark side and everything else. I spent all my years being hounded by my instructors, being told so often how gifted and important I was until I was sick of it. I remember when I was younger, I used to swear that I would never become as self-absorbed and stodgy as the Jedi Masters. It's ironic, really.
Don't forget about being critical, cold, and secretive. Even to me.
Yes, well, there's no need for you to agree so wholeheartedly. Being controlled has kept everyone around me at an arm's length. Even those like yourself who are most in need of my understanding and compassion. Maybe it's time to change that. You deserve to know how much I respect and admire you. I had to tell you how much I care for you. As a friend, of course.
Bastila, this bond, our connection. I've never felt this intimate with someone before. And I think you feel the same.
Please, it's not allowed. I have to remain true to the Jedi ideal. If this is going to cause a problem, maybe I shouldn't have said anything.
No, I'm glad that you did. I'm sorry that I was too forward. Oh, looks like they're finally ready for us. Put them free, 2-3. Masters, we've found the star maps on both Tatooine and Kashyyyk.
You have done well so far, Dann. What is your next destination?
Our next destination is Afo City on Manan. The ship's being fueled as we speak.
Very good. Be careful in your travels, Dann. The range and deception of the Sith is unknown.
Yeah, we've encountered that too, and I don't think we've seen the last of them.
You must not fail in your mission, young Padawan.
You are following in Revan and Malak's footsteps. Wherever you go, danger will always be there. But you are ready for this.
With all due respect, Masters, I am fully aware of the danger that is coming.
The lure of the dark side is difficult to resist.
And I think you're underestimating me, Master Vrook.
You must learn patience and discipline.
And you need to learn to start trusting me.
How dare you?
Peace, Masters. I'm sure Dann did not mean to offend you.
No, I know what I meant. You think this is easy, tracking these star maps? My head is filled with visions of a dead Sith Lord and his apprentice is trying to kill me. Don't start patronizing me like I'm some youngling.
Such arrogance.
You see shadows where there are none and hate where there is none.
You've just confirmed everything I thought about you.
T3, lose the signal.
It troubles me to see you behaving this way.
Ever brash, ever disrespectful. This is what we have pinned our hopes on.
Peace, Rook.
Then maybe you should be a bit more supportive, Rook. We've lost enough Jedi to the Sith as it is. We cannot keep pushing our own away. Look at what we did after the war. Like so many others, we pushed him away, and now we're doing the same to Dann Kasra. That was quite the show, my friend.
I'm glad I impressed you, Master.
While I sympathize with your situation, you must learn to control emotions. You are not in the military anymore. A Jedi must be better.
I know. It's just hard.
You have a monumental challenge ahead of you. I wish I could be there with you.
Yeah, that'd be nice. Honestly, I'll take all the guidance I can get. I just feel so lost at times, and the Council chastising my every move isn't helping.
Don't worry about the Masters. I'll keep them off your back. Keep doing what you're doing.
Thank you, Master.
But this anger, this fire you have, remember what I told you?
Yeah, if I let it, it will destroy me.
You remind me of him in many ways. You know, Revan.
You knew Revan?
Not well. I witnessed his training on occasion, and I was there when he left the Order to fight the Mandalorians.
What happened to him, exactly?
Against the Council's wishes, Revan and Malak left the Order to aid the Republic in the war. They couldn't stand by as the Republic cried for help.
I can't blame him. The Republic needed the Jedi.
No one is denying that Revan was one of the keys to defeating the Mandalorians, but something happened out there on the Outer Rim. Instead of returning after the war's end, the ships under Revan's command went deep into unknown space. They claimed to be searching for the last remnants of the Mandalorian fleet. All contact was lost. For many months, it was assumed both Revan and Malak were dead. 3 years ago, Revan and Malak returned at the head of a massive Sith invasion fleet. Revan had assumed the title of Sith Lord. The hero had become a conqueror.
But this fleet, where did it come from?
That is one of the many mysteries of the Sith we cannot explain. A logical suggestion would be that the fleet was constructed out of the Republic warships under Revan's command. But even those wouldn't account for half of his Sith armada. Revan was a brilliant leader, a master tactician on the battlefield, and a fierce opponent in combat. For 2 years, the Sith were all but unstoppable, until the trap laid by the Jedi, resulting in Revan's death.
Yeah, the strike team that Bastila was a part of. You know, somehow, I don't think we're going to be as lucky this time.
In my experience, there's no such thing as luck. Trust your instincts, Dann. You will find a way.
Thank you, Master. I just hope I don't let you down. Well, the meeting with the Council was less than ideal. You've been very quiet lately, you know that.
Have I been quiet? Suppose I have. I guess I just don't like being left out of the loop.
What do you mean?
Left out of the loop, you know, not being told anything, strung along. It's really starting to irritate me. For one thing, I want to know what the Jedi Council said to you. They pulled you in there and refused to tell me a thing about it.
Karf, I don't know. The Council is just as big a mystery to me. Why don't you ask Bastila?
I'd be more than happy to, but she's as closed-mouthed as the rest of the Council. I'm hoping you'll be the one to enlighten me.
I don't know what you want me to say. They thought I was better off looking for the star maps.
And why is that? You were a great help on Terrace, but why would they keep you with us? Don't they have to train you? You're a neophyte Padawan who's been saddled with the responsibility of tracking down these star maps. Why? That's not normal.
Why? You don't think I'm capable of looking after myself?
No, I don't... I didn't mean that you weren't wanted, or that I want to go, it's just... Damn it! I am not trying to provoke you, or to imply that you're somehow responsible for the Jedi Council, but give me a hand here, there has to be a reason. Well, I'll tell you this much, I'm not going to wait around until I'm betrayed again.
And I'm not going to betray you, Karf. I'm not Saul.
Yeah, we'll just see about that, won't we?
There's a bond between Bastila and myself. And that's all they told me. Honestly, Karf.
A bond? What kind of bond? You mean to say that they told you that you were tied to Bastila in some way? Huh. I have trouble believing that.
Oh, come on. I've been open with you. That's more than you are with me sometimes.
Look, I didn't mean it that way. I want to get to Saul, not... No, no.
What is it?
Forget it. It just seems that all I can do is insult you, isn't it?
Cough.
Just forget I said anything. Let's just get on with what we were doing.
I'm sorry, Cuff. I didn't mean to upset you. But we need to have each other's backs, and I can't do that if you keep shutting me out like this. This is all about your past with Saul, isn't it?
It's just that I don't talk about it very much, okay? I told you about my homeworld, Telos. 4 years ago, Saul led the Sith fleet there and demanded its surrender. The planet refused, and Saul proceeded to devastate its entire surface. Millions died. I had a wife and a son on Telos. I thought they would be safe there, but my task force arrived too late to be of much help. We didn't have enough medical supplies. The colony was burning and the dying were everywhere. I remember holding my wife and screaming for the medics, but they didn't come in time.
Cough, I didn't know it was that personal. I'm sorry. I guess I can't blame your anger.
Of course not. How could you? I had nothing left after that, really. I devoted myself to the fleet. Hunting Saul was my only purpose.
What about your son?
His name was Dustal, and I don't know what happened to him. The colony was a complete ruin, and we never found any trace of him. I miss them, and I know killing Saul won't bring them back. And it won't make me happy again, but I have to do it. I've never talked about it before to anyone. Suppose it's time I finally did. I don't expect you to understand, but I have to pay him back for what he's done. I have to. It's all I have left.
I didn't mean to pry, but... I appreciate you telling me, Cuff. We will find Saul, and we will bring him to justice.
Anyway, I hope that answers your questions. Let's continue with what we were doing.
Put
him through. Do not waste my time, Admiral Dinn. What do you have to report?
Takum just tak miki grabal mogo. Kachi chu aithao donga tulpada bong molya gando danago chulchut. Moga shampungpa bulawana chik.
You were specifically ordered not to engage the enemy until you had my authorization. I hope for your sake that your discovery justifies this insubordination.
Rundi hautunga kuhunga pi wana kunbes jink palamul tong kimba na kungek.
Is that so? And you believe this justifies your defiance?
Jashank pogra hul wanchiska nichu achuba chiska wanki.
It was a reckless decision to attack without my permission.
Mucha hotonga yofulki. Chachiska to punta casa bubak bana oto. We itanatana itia.
But why would you have been taken by surprise when we have known for some time it is now common practice for Jedi to be integrated within Republic fleets? Did that small detail slip your mind, Admiral? Or did you perhaps not bother to read the intelligence reports? And now knowing that we are aware of their military buildup, the Republic may rethink their strategy, or withdraw from this sector entirely, causing us to fail to learn of their motives here.
Mana mana tota! Aku jigra tuk pola! Jishok chonatong!
No! You have failed me for the last time, Admiral Adin.
Pamulira kunkili! Kunkili no pa!
It's time for us to join the battle. The Republic will soon learn the consequences of challenging the Sith Empire.
Hey, Jahani.
How may I be of assistance to you, Padawan?
I was just thinking that we hadn't really had much of a chance to chat since Tatooine.
What is it you would like to speak to me about?
Well, how about how you became a Jedi?
How I came to be a Jedi? I am sure you would not find it very interesting. Are you sure you would like to hear?
Of course I would.
Back on my homeworld, we did not see Jedi very often, especially where I lived.
I thought you would have been back on K'thar. Where did you live then?
The hind end of space. A pit of a world, to be sure, where Jedi rarely tread. But we had heard of them. Well, everyone had, so that is not to be unexpected. Champions of truth, defenders of justice, heroes of the Republic. It was very easy for a child to be enthralled by their image, their mystique. Maybe I was one of those children.
Did you meet any Jedi before you joined?
Yes. Yes, I did. When I saw a Jedi for the first time, they lived up to everything my imagination had created them to be. I was awed, and maybe a little enamored. They were quite striking, especially the tales of their leader. From that moment on, I knew that I would have to try to become a Jedi, to lift myself out of the rut I had been living in for years, and to make a real difference, as the Jedi were. The foolish delusions of a child. But this child made it happen. As soon as I was able, I left my world and went in search of them. I found them and was accepted. I had been living my dream on Dantooine for several years before you came.
So these Jedi that you met, what were they like?
They were so very alive. So full of hope and energy and zeal. In retrospect, I can see it was a little bit tragic.
Tragic? How so?
These Jedi were going to fight the Mandalorians just after they had invaded. Many of those Jedi perished in the fighting.
Where was this?
A rat hole, a warren, a paradise. I suppose you could call it all these things.
Jahani?
Taris! It was Taris that the Sith destroyed to try to kill you and your precious Bastila. Taris, my homeworld.
Jahani, I'm sorry. But you can't blame me for that, surely. That was Malak's doing.
If it were not for you and Bastila, the Sith would have never had reason to destroy that world. It was your fault for being there, and your fault for rescuing Bastila.
Jahani, I'm sorry.
Just let me vent my anger. I need someone to blame. Something. Anything.
There was no way to prevent it. We had to get off that planet as quickly as possible.
I know. I suppose I realized that. But it is so hard to lose your entire past. You would not understand.
So, Manan. Anyone know anything about this place?
Manan's a neutral world. They're the only source of Kolto, the healing fluid.
That's why those fish-faced Selkath can stay neutral in this whole Sith Republic war.
Water worlds never had much of an appeal for us to conquer. They may put up a good fight on their own environment. No match for us, of course. But they don't really have anything of value, either.
Statement. Indeed. My talents are wasted in this overgrown swimming pool, Master.
Yeah, that's really helpful, guys. What do we know about the natives here? The Selkath?
Squishy meatbags.
HK.
They are known to be very dreary, and strong proponents of the power of law above all else.
Alright, so recap. There's only one city above the water's surface, the rest of the planet is a giant ocean, there are both Republic and Sith forces here bound by a treaty of no violence, and the natives are giant talking fish people. Well, it should be fine.
Manan's an unusual place.
Yeah, no kidding. Okay guys, let's head out. We should probably start by asking around in the cantinas. That's how these things usually go.
Jolie, may I have a moment? There's something I wish to speak to you about.
Yep, I figured it was only a matter of time until we had the whole come back to the order discussion. Well, I guess there's no avoiding it now, so let's get it over with.
I know you have issues with the Order, but you are a Jedi, Jolie. You command the Force. Without the guidance of the Council, how can you avoid falling to the dark side?
Well, I've managed to avoid it the last 20 years or so. Besides, light side, dark side, they don't mean the same to me as they do to you. I don't see in absolutes.
How do you figure that?
I want to stop Malak as much as anyone. But I don't have to join the Order to do it. Look at Karth, or Candorus. They're with us in this quest, but they aren't Jedi. The capacity for good or evil, like the Force itself, is in all living creatures. And belonging to the Jedi Order, or the Sith, or any group, won't change what you are at your core.
I see you are quite adamant. No doubt you've had ample time to think on this during your long seclusion. I guess it was foolish of me to think I could sway your position so easily.
Yeah, I'm old and stubborn. But I appreciate the effort. But from now on, you can just think of me as any other non-Jedi in our little group. With a lightsaber. And Force powers.
As deep and as philosophical as this has been, we should keep moving. The city entrance is just ahead.
Save your empty threats, Sith scum. Malak isn't stupid enough to attack the core worlds, not with the entire Republic fleet waiting for him.
You're a fool. When the Sith descend on Coruscant, our numbers will block out the sun itself. The galactic senators will collapse trembling in fear and beg for mercy at Malak's feet. Remember what happened to Taris. Malak could do the same to the core worlds.
He wouldn't dare.
Now it is you who underestimate our resolve.
This is ridiculous. It's so crowded. We're never going to find anyone of interest in here. Honestly, I feel no safer here than I did back on Tatooine. Something's troubling you again, isn't it?
Am I so transparent? I suppose I shouldn't be surprised, considering our bond. Yes, there is something I would like to ask, if you'll permit it.
What is it?
In our time together, I've been watching you. You are a true servant of the light. You follow the tenets of the Jedi Order despite the lure of the dark side. And with so little training, for me it has always been a constant battle. Don't you find it difficult at all? You make it seem so easy. Or is that only an illusion?
Trust me, it's not easy for me either. I feel like I'm only just about holding on at times. But you help, Bastila. You help get me through this.
If only it were as easy for me. I've always struggled for control over my passions. I've always been too quick to anger, too quick to get involved. My instructors constantly berated me for it.
You, a hothead? No way.
I've often dreamed that I might be able to confront Darth Malak myself. I dream I can use all this power I have to kill him and stop all the death and destruction.
Bastila.
I just think about all the evil that the Sith have caused and I get so furious. Yet we are told that these feelings are the path to the dark side. The very thought that I could become as evil as Malak, I just can't fathom it. It just doesn't seem possible. I mean, how could I... No. Wait, I'm sorry. I shouldn't even be asking you this. The Jedi teachings are clear. Who am I to question them? Even worse, who am I to try and make you question them?
Bastila, it's fine. You know you can talk to me.
These are dangerous thoughts. The indulgence of a vain mind. Please, forget I ever mentioned this. Let's just return to our mission.
Well, look what we've got here. Easy pickings.
That's a Wookiee. Wow, I didn't even know they were allowed off Kashyyyk.
They're not all slaves, you idiot. Well, not yet, at least.
I don't know. I bet he fetches a good price.
He talks, too.
He could do wonders in our warehouses. Save us the heavy lifting.
Leave him alone, you core slimes!
Oh, this just keeps getting better and better.
What are you doing here alone, little girl?
Who you calling little girl, Chuba Face?
You shut her!
Is there a problem here?
These your pets, Jedi? You want to get them in line? That girl has got quite a mouth on her.
Yeah, we'd hate for them to go missing and turn up in the ocean.
Oh yeah? Try it, big man. You'll be the one floating in the water.
You dare!
This Jedi and his friends accosted us in the middle of our drinks. He's just made a threat against my colleague.
Not at all. The Sith officers and I are merely exchanging meaningless taunts. Unless they wish to make something of it.
There, you see, officer?
I saw the whole thing, officer. The Sith gentleman started it.
Lies!
The Sith started it. You will remove them from the cantina.
What?
The Sith will not stand for this, Jedi!
Thanks for the hand.
Just buy me a drink sometime. I should be going.
Hey!
Yes?
That's a Republic uniform, right? I used to be in the military myself.
Well, thank you for your service. But I must be going.
Wait, hang on. I'm on a mission from the Jedi Council. Perhaps you can help me. Can you help?
Not here. Meet me at the Republic Embassy in an hour. An ancient star map from a forgotten race. And you think it might be here on Manan.
So you do know something?
Perhaps. As you know, the Republic is fighting for its very existence against the evil of the Sith Empire. The Selkath Conservatives, and with their neutrality treaties, seek to treat the Sith and the Republic equally. This includes Koto exports.
That's ridiculous. How can they not see the evil of the Sith?
Well, it would seem they do not see things as black and white as you and I do. At any rate, a few more far-sighted Selkath see that if the Sith are ever allowed to win, the galaxy would be plunged into darkness, and there would be nothing preventing the Sith from taking this world anyway. So, we made a deal.
You violated the treaty. That's very risky.
Yes, I know. It was worth it, or so we initially thought. We recently began construction of a secret underground facility to harvest Koto at its source. We were nearing completion of the base when the digging teams reported some sort of obstruction, some ancient device. Possibly your star map transmissions from the base were cut off abruptly after that, and we haven't heard from the station since. We sent several rescue teams down, none of which have returned.
I have to get down there. If the star map's down there, I need to be there too, and I'll try and look for any survivors.
I've taken the liberty of having a submersible prepared for your departure. Please, you must find out what happened at the facility, and rescue any survivors.
I'll do my best. HK.
Master.
Tell Bastila and Jolie we're ready to descend.
Statement. Master, the chances of you finding the star map down there, let alone surviving the descent, are next to zero.
Look, I don't want to hear any more of your odds, HK. We don't have a choice. Look it out there. It's just darkness.
Frightful.
Yeah, you can say that again.
Do not make this any harder on yourself than necessary. I need some answers from you.
Well, this isn't creepy at all. Door short-circuited. T3? Something isn't right here. I feel uneasy.
See? Now you know how I feel half the time.
Sith spit. Looks like he was mauled to death. But by what? There can't be any animal life on this station. Yeah, you said it. Something is very wrong here. It's locked. See what you can do, T3. This is wonderful. Stuck in some creepy underwater base whilst the Council is safe back on Dantooine.
You must learn to trust in the wisdom of the Council. Your destiny will come when its appointed time. You mustn't be so impatient.
If you say so. But honestly, I don't even know why I'm here.
Why? I could not accomplish this on my own. I need the aid of others. Especially one who is strong in the Force. The bond between us made you a natural choice.
Huh. What are the odds of that?
There is little left to chance when the Force is involved. Is that not enough for you?
No, it is. Sorry, I just don't trust the Council and their motives. When they gave us this task, I thought that... I don't know what I thought, really. I just can't help but doubt them now.
I admit, there were times that I wondered if this is more than just a mission to stop Malak. There were times when I wondered if this was also a way for the Council to test my own abilities. And then I realized how foolish such thoughts were.
Wait, hang on a second. The Force wants us to be together. Why do you keep resisting my undeniable charm?
I said we were brought together for our mission, to stop Malak. I hardly think the Force would be pushing us toward a romantic involvement when the fate of the galaxy is at stake.
Oh, sure, sure.
Please try to stay focused. I doubt the Council would approve if they knew we were busy discussing our mutual attraction when we
should... Mutual attraction? Well, I'm glad to hear it's mutual, at least.
Mutual attraction? I never said... It's just an expression.
Well, looks like we're in. Nice job, little guy. It looks like there's another station to the east, but, we need to go out onto the floor of the ocean. There's a diving suit here in Section 15. Let's go. Hello? Stay back, guys. Can you hear me? We've been sent by the Republic. Are you okay? Did you not hear what I just said? What's happened to you? Where is everyone? Look, no offense, but I've come a very long way. Could you just tell me... Okay, this is not good.
Why do you pursue me? Leave. Now.
Yeah, okay. Let's go. Oh, this is really not good. Section 14 is just up ahead. Come on, guys. Please stop. We don't want to hurt you. T3, sometime today. Oh, this is insane.
You have ventured too far, surface dweller.
Oh yeah? See ya. What was that? A signal? What kind of signal? T3 says he detected a strong signal radiating from the cell calf. Nothing like he's ever read before. I've had enough of this. Get me Roland 1. Oh, of course. No signal.
Not this again!
Run! We're almost there. Bastila, hurry!
I'm sorry.
Open that door right now.
Don't be insane. The cell cath are right out there.
So is my friend.
If your friend is out there, then she's dead. I'm sorry.
You open that door right now, or there'll be another death.
I can't.
Don't say no to me.
Even if I wanted to, I couldn't.
I deadlock sealed the other room. Computer protocols won't reopen it for another 30 minutes.
Damn it!
I'm sorry.
Right, Jolie, we're leaving.
We told you, idiot. It's sealed. Deadlocked. We're stuck in here.
You've murdered her.
You signed your death warrants yourself the second you came down here.
Hey, kid.
Not now, Jolie. I'm fine. I just need to get out of here.
I'm sure you are, but you have to take time to listen.
Oh, it's them.
More little residents of the surface have come to my domain.
Show yourself. You'll see how little I am.
Look at you, clinging to your machinery to keep you safe from the ocean's embrace.
It isn't the Selkath. Something's speaking through them.
But I am patient. I will wait out here in the dark for the waters to take you.
I'm Dann Kasra, Jedi Padawan. Who are you?
A Jedi? I have watched countless civilizations rise and fall. More wars and conflict than you could ever imagine. And you come here, to my home, proclaiming yourself a man of war.
The Jedi seek to protect and serve the Republic. We're not warriors.
Are you not? One man's protector is another's dictator. I have watched your prestigious order fail to aid those in need, time and time again.
You're wrong.
You know nothing.
What do you want? We came here in peace.
You will die, all of you. This base will be your graves.
What are you exactly? Some figment of the dark side?
I am from a time long before. And I will be here long after your demise. I was born nearly 20 revolutions before this planet inhabited all other forms of life.
That's not possible. No life existed back then.
Is that your belief? Something you tell yourself at night to sleep easily?
Wait a minute. The droid we encountered on Dantooine, it said it existed long before the formation of the Republic. Is that you then? Are you one of these builders, remnant of a long-forgotten race?
Even before them.
This is a waste of time. You don't intimidate me.
Listen to you, so scared of being a leader, trying so valiantly to remain in control. I see through you, human. The darkness cannot be breached.
I'm done with this. I'm coming for you, and for your sake, my friend better be alive. Screw you.
Great. Not like that was our only way of contacting the surface.
If you were going to receive any communications, you would have by now. How long is left on the deadlock?
25 minutes.
What's your name?
Eric Cord. This is Kiever Noth. We were part of the maintenance crew on the base.
What the hell happened here? Well?
We woke something up.
Eric!
Come on, Kiever, look around you. Screw company policy.
But if the Selkath find out we broke the peace treaty, they'll...
Look, Kiever, I've had a really long day. My friend might be dead. Don't piss me off.
We came down with the initial team to secure the base. We were trying to harvest the Kolto.
Oh yeah, I know all about the Republic's little secret.
We had no choice. The Sith gain leverage on this world by the day.
As we neared completion on the base, we detected irregular energy readings from the eastern side. So, we sent a diving team to investigate.
The star map.
Whatever they found, something was guarding it. It was huge! Like nothing we'd ever recorded. The diving team never returned, but there was this noise. Oh, it was so loud! Like nothing I'd ever heard before.
And whatever it was, it turned all the Selkath workers insane. They killed anyone on sight.
I need to get out there.
Don't be ridiculous!
I'm going with or without your help. Anything? Not far from here, then.
What will you do?
There's an airlock not far from here. I have to get out there and stop this.
You'll be killed.
I'd rather die trying than sit in here like a coward.
I've got about an hour's oxygen in this thing. Should be enough.
You'll both be dead long before then anyway.
Thanks for the moral support. I'll stay in radio contact. I'll try my best.
Suffered heavy losses in several key sectors. Our scouts report masses of Sith activity along the Outer Rim.
What of the advance guard? Any activity?
No, sir. All ships report silence along the core systems. It's stable for now.
Very well. Thank you for your report, Captain. Well, no need for any immediate panic, then.
Forgive me, Master Bullock, but how does this not warrant concern?
Malak's forces are at bay for now. This fear-mongering of an attack on the core worlds is unprecedented.
This threat is coming right to us, and the Council is content to do nothing?
Peace, Master Malvaro. The Republic will do an adequate job guarding the core systems. Malak would be foolish to stage an attack at this stage.
Should Darth Malak launch such an assault, we are pledged to protect this world. The fleets will hold. Master.
I hope you're right.
Is that all then?
No, there is still the other matter, one of which I'm sure you are familiar with, Malvaro.
Yes, Dann Kasra. I'm curious, was this a wise decision?
We should not have let him depart.
The decision was not of my making, Master Saurus. Perhaps you should consult with Master Vrook as to why it was put forward to the Council.
We should have told him the truth. A Jedi deserves to know.
No good would have come from it.
Lying to our own is the best path.
We are in agreement on the matter, Malvaro.
Are we?
We cannot turn away our only hope.
And so it comes to this.
I fear it is our teachings that may have...
We are not the ones who taught him.
This will not end well for any of us.
And that is the future we must accept.
The plan remains for now. Should events come to pass, we know what we must do. We only tell him if absolutely necessary.
Until then, he must accept his journey.
So this is what it comes down to, for everything. Hoping on a plan to succeed, instead of having the will to act.
And I suppose you have another idea, Malvaro?
No, I don't. But this is the High Jedi Council. We are the protectors of the Republic. Surely we can do better.
You must be mindful of your emotions, Master Malvaro. Nothing good will come from your irrational fear.
I seem to recall you saying the same when Mandalore threatened to burn this planet.
That is enough, Master Malvaro. The High Council is in agreement. Dann Kasra will continue with his mission for now.
Made it onto the ocean floor, heading to the signal source now.
Try not to get Eric killed, Jedi. And, good luck down there, I guess.
This is something you don't see every day. It's quite peaceful out here.
Close as we can get to the signal from here.
What's with the bridge?
Constructed during the initial assembly of the base, but we never finished it. That walkway leads down to the object we discovered, but whatever we woke up destroyed it.
The signal, it's nearly 100 feet below us from here. How far down can these suits go?
What? You're crazy! You'd be lost down there!
The suit has a propelling system. Our way back up.
Assuming you even make it down there, your suit could collapse from the ocean's pressure before you even come close to the bottom.
That's a chance I have to take. You wait here. Who knows what signal I'll have down there.
You've got balls, Jedi. I'll give you that. Is this really worth it?
It's the only way to save Bastila, I think. I've got no choice. If I don't make it back, if you find her and I'm not there, tell her...
Tell her what?
Oh, she knows.
Dann!
To the bottom, continuing on. That looks like a star map. About time. Guys, I found the map.
Dann, watch out! I'm picking up a...
Guys? Hello? Anyone? Progenitor is nothing more than a myth, a superstitious legend allegedly responsible for creating the Cellcalf.
And yet here I am. You may believe what you will, but I am dying to learn more about you, human.
This is not your domain. And still, I must wonder, where does your journey lead, Dann Kasra? Your memories give voice to my words. Your nature will be revealed to me.
All you had to do was ask.
I have no need of your consent.
I need access to that star map.
Why?
Because I'm the only one who can stop Darth Malak.
Darth Malak. Fascinating titles. I have searched your mind. You are an anomaly. Yet it is not enough.
Not enough? We're at war with the Sith. I'm trying to stop them, the very same Sith that are trying to occupy your world.
And what does it matter? The Sith and the Jedi have waged war with one another for thousands of years. I have witnessed countless empires rise and fall. The Purebloods, Exar Kun, the Prime Jedi, and the Hundred Year Darkness. Yet each time, both sides rise again.
No, not this time. I can stop them.
Merely years ago, the precious Republic your Jedi sought to protect warred with another faction, the Mandalorians. The same Republic that desecrated this site. What is the point?
We beat the Mandalorians, and we will beat the Sith. Hide down here if you will, but I'm going to stop them.
Your confidence is singular.
Yeah, I know. I think I've earned it.
Who is the woman?
She's my friend. She's my friend and she's out there alone. I have to save her.
Interesting.
I'm sorry for what's happened here. I'm sorry that Republic has trespassed on your domain, but you have to let me and all the Selkath you've taken control of go.
Why?
Because I'm telling you to.
Yes, but why you? What makes you special?
I don't know. Nothing.
Does it matter?
Perhaps not. You are like a dancer on the battlefield, Dann Kasra. An immovable force.
No, I'm not. I'm just trying my best to help him. I'm not sure I can do it, okay? I'm trying so hard, and I just feel this anger in me all the time.
Perhaps there is more to you than what your Jedi superiors have told you.
There's nothing special about me. I just have to keep going.
You impress me, human. The one who came before you spoke with the same integrity and confidence.
The one who came before? You mean Revan?
The Dark One who sought the map. Yes.
Revan is dead.
Interesting. Yet something about you feels familiar. Perhaps you are destined for a similar path.
Look, I don't have time for this. What is the map to you? Why won't you release me?
The precursors to your kind placed it here as a monument of their achievement. They came to me, asking me to be its protector. Only those I deemed worthy were to be granted access.
Yeah, the Builders. Heard of them. You gave Revan access, so what about me?
You match the correct pattern. You are deemed worthy. But a request in return, I must ask.
Can't believe I'm swapping favors with a talking fish. What is it?
Your kind, your Republic, will leave this site alone, and you will speak nothing of this encounter to my descendants.
I swear it, you will be left alone. And what about the Selkath under your control?
They will be released, and will retain no memory of this transgression. Sense a presence about you, Jedi. You have more power than you know.
Right. Well, that was different.
Jedi.
one more to go.
Dann, do you read me?
I'm here, Eric. I'm coming up now.
I don't know what you did down there, but I'm getting high-pressure warnings on my suit. It's going off the chart.
Just go. Get out of here. I'll be right behind you.
What? Don't be insane. You'll never make it up in time.
Just go, Eric. There's nothing you can do to help. I'm not having another death on my hands.
God, blast it.
Just a bit further.
36 seconds to complete depressurization.
Come on.
24 seconds to complete depressurization.
Not now. Not like this. I'm not done yet.
18 seconds to complete depressurization. 12 seconds to complete depressurization.
Bastila. I'm sorry.
6 seconds to complete depressurization.
Bastila!
The Cellcath, they got in, but they just let her go. Where's Dann?
What happened?
Something happened down there. The water pressure, I think... I'm sorry. Dann! You made it!
You were expecting anything else?
Bastila, I thought I'd lost you.
Anyone gonna fill me in on what just happened?
I don't believe it.
Yeah, neither do I. But it's true. You can trust me on that.
This news is most disturbing. A giant talking shark. The Cellcath. Their superstitions. It's all true!
You mustn't say a word of this to the Cellcath, Roland. I gave it my word. And trust me, you don't want to piss that thing off.
Of course.
And you must abandon the base immediately.
The diplomatic corps won't be happy. That was our edge. What do I say to them?
You'll think of something, but that base is never to be touched again. Let the ocean take it.
Very well, Jedi. Most of the Cellcath personnel have returned to the city as it is. They don't seem to remember anything about it.
Let's keep it that way, then.
I agree. I wish you luck with your mission, Dann.
What will you guys do now?
Well, we got a lot of readings from that base. There's much to study.
That data needs to remain hidden, Eric.
Don't be absurd.
Look, I made that thing, the progenitor, a promise. No one must learn of his existence. Report back to your superiors, but tell them nothing of what happened here.
Lying, huh? I guess the Jedi really are masters of deceit.
Listen, you, I've had a-
I understand, Dann. We won't say a word of what happened.
Damn Jedi.
You had me scared down there for a while, you know? What is it?
Part of my purpose on this mission was to guide you in the way of the light, to help you avoid the temptations of the dark side. But I fear I've failed in that task.
Bastila, not this again.
I don't think I'm the proper Jedi to guide you. I am no master.
What are you trying to say?
You should have remained with the Council.
You can't be serious.
The fact of the matter is, I have never possessed much skill at controlling myself. With the bond that joins us, it seems I have even less.
Bastila, we have to be there for each other. Like with your mother, and now. Screw the Council and their rules. I was not going to leave you down there, and I'm not going anywhere now either.
You continue to be there for me, don't you? Even after I keep pushing you away, you're still around when I need you most. You're like no man I've known before, and you're nothing like what I expected you to be after the Council sent us on this mission together.
What are you saying?
I need time to think about all this. Things have... they're not going as I thought they would.
So, good chat? This is just getting ridiculous. Just tell her how you feel, Dann. Well, yeah, easier said than done. I can't. I'm a Jedi. I'm not supposed to feel like that. Well, screw the Jedi. What the hell?
You.
Time's up, Jedi.
You coward. Attacking innocent civilians.
I thought that would get your blood pumping.
Why? Why do this? You could have just killed me on Kashyyyk.
What's the harm in a little sport?
Sick and twisted. You won't harm anyone else.
Oh, I've been looking forward to this. That's it. Use your anger.
Sending me to fight. When I bring him your head, perhaps his reign is at an end.
Ah, Sith tradition. How civilized. Show yourself. Bastard.
Oh, this was meant to be.
Don't touch her! Are you all right? Well, hopefully that's the last we'll see of him. Sith scum.
Very good, Dann Kasra. Very good indeed.
Inform Lord Malak we are in position. You may fire when ready.
We need to get out of here!
With all my training, I should be able to control myself better than this. But you're not like anything I expected. You're not like any man I've ever met before. I find myself watching you when I don't mean to. I'm thinking about you when I don't want to. It isn't supposed to be like this.
It is supposed to be like this.
Every time I try to call on all my teachings to calm myself, they fail me. You have such power, such passion. I don't know if it's due to the bond between us, but I'm drawn to you.
So what are you saying?
You're stronger than I am, and there's no point in telling me otherwise. You will be a great Jedi, I think. I hope. In some ways, you make me feel weak, like I'm caught up in the wake of our destiny. But at the same time, you make me feel stronger, more alive. I realize now these feelings are part of the bond we share. The Jedi Council surely realized this. They knew my loyalty to the doctrines of our order would be tested on this mission.
Wait, what?
By facing and overcoming my feelings for you, I've learned a valuable lesson about control and the dangers of emotion. I'm sorry if this is not what you wanted to hear, but I felt that it was important you know our infatuation was nothing more than a result of our powerful bond.
You're damn right it isn't. Why are you lying to yourself? You're just afraid to face the truth.
You're the one who can't face the truth. Malak has to be stopped. How can I do that if I let myself be blinded by my feelings for you?
Bastila, I'm going to stop Malak. But I want to do it with you at my side. I need you at my side.
You mean it, don't you? But how can I be sure you're not making a mistake? I have to resist. I have to be strong for both of us.
No, you don't. Don't deny this any longer.
But I don't... I mean, I can't. Malak will... We shouldn't have done that. It was wrong. The Jedi are not allowed to fall in love.
It didn't feel wrong to me.
It was a moment of weakness. When I kissed you, we shouldn't have. I'm sorry, no. I know we both wanted it, but we shouldn't have given in to our desire. We're Jedi, we can't act like this.
Bastila, come on.
I'm sorry. I don't blame you, but it was a mistake. I have to get out of here before somebody sees us together.
Just my luck.
Got something on your mind, do you?
I don't even know where to begin. I'm just really... What the hell is that?
What's going on?
Sith interdictor ship. They must have been waiting for us on the hyperspace route. We're caught in their tractor beam.
Do you recognize the ship?
It's the Leviathan. Saul Kareth's vessel. My old mentor.
No escape this time, Jedi.
There's nothing we can do.
If I get a chance to kill Saul during our escape, nobody better get in my way.
Talk of an escape is somewhat premature, don't you think? We don't even have a plan to get out of this mess yet.
Saul's no fool, and he won't underestimate us either. You can count on plenty of guards watching every move we make.
Maybe Admiral Kareth doesn't know how many of us there are on board. We all have special talents. Talents we could exploit so that one of us could stage a rescue.
That's a start.
The Admiral will be watching the three of us far too closely for any plot involving you, me, or Kareth to succeed. It's going to be up to one of the others to get us out of this.
Well, if we're gonna pick someone to save our skins, we better do it quick. In another minute, we're gonna have Sith troops marching up our loading ramp.
HK, could you do it?
Assessment. I will not be able to hide myself from the Sith forces, Master. However, Sith war protocols dictate that any captured droid units must be taken to engineering for a memory wipe and reassignment. Should someone else be able to reactivate me before that happens, I can slice into the ship's security functions.
No, T3. You've got no real defensive abilities. I'm not losing you. We need someone who can remain hidden.
I alone of all the group might be able to remain hidden if the Sith search the ship.
Are you sure you're up to this?
I could wait until the guards have completed their search, then come to rescue you.
Agreement. Yes, the cat-like meatbag shows excellent logic. Her camouflage abilities will allow her to sneak past enemy lines and reactivate me.
Alright, it's a plan. Good luck, everyone.
Reassurance. Do not worry, Tiny Bucket. No harm shall come to you. Should the day come when you are finally ready to be destroyed, I shall be pulling the trigger.
That's oddly touching.
Bastila, Kareth, and the crew have been taken prisoner as you ordered, Commander.
Excellent. Have you searched the ship thoroughly? Admiral Kareth warned me to be on alert for any kind of treachery.
We found a disabled hunter-killer droid in the back of the ship.
Excellent. We can reprogram this droid to fight in our own army, wipe its memory chip, and take it to the salvage shop. Technicians will deal with it later.
Kareth, it has been far too long since we last spoke. I see the recent months have not been kind in your case. I barely recognized you.
But I recognize you, Saul. I see your face every night, even as I promise myself I will kill you for what you did to my homeworld.
Did you learn nothing in your time under me? This was an act of war.
It was a cowardly act of betrayal. Your fleet bombed a civilian target into oblivion without warning or provocation, and the blood of those innocent people is on your hands.
The Sith would not accept me until I proved I had truly turned my back on the Republic by bombing the planet.
Yeah, I'm sure you were really conflicted about it.
My wife died in that attack, Saul. And for that, I swear I'll kill you.
You used to be a man of action, not of empty words. Cling to your lust for revenge if you must, but spare me your tired threats. I've heard them all before. You're an insignificant part of these events anyway. Lord Malak is far more interested in your Jedi companions. He has great plans for them.
We will never serve Malak or the dark side. The Sith will be destroyed, Admiral Carath, as will you if you don't turn away from this path.
Your words are brave, Bastila, but the lure of the dark side is hard to resist, or so I've been told. I wonder if your companion is as devoted to the light as you are.
Go to hell, Saul.
You're defiant. I'm certain Malak will find your loyalty to the Jedi amusing. The Dark Lord would probably reward me if I just killed you once and for all, but he may want to question you given the trouble you've caused him, and the history between you.
Well, let me guess. Big Bald Man isn't a fan of my work.
You mean... Oh, this can't be true, can it? You really don't know what's going on here, do you? Well, I won't be the one to deprive Malak of the pleasure of telling you himself. The Dark Lord will no doubt torture you for information and for his own twisted pleasure. Eventually, you will tell him everything. The Sith can be very persuasive. However, Lord Malak is in another sector. It may be some time before he arrives, so I suppose I will have to fill in for him until then. Activate the torture fields. Enough. I don't want them to pass out before I question them.
Don't waste your breath, Saul. We won't answer any of your questions.
I'm sure you won't. However, we both know your friends' loyalties have proven in the past to be somewhat... flexible.
What are you talking about?
It is time to put your loyalty to the test. I doubt torturing you will gain me your true cooperation. Your will is too strong to be broken that way. However, even the strongest of heroes has trouble watching those they care about suffering.
Saul, stop this.
My pain is meaningless. Tell him nothing.
I tire of these games. Now I want answers. On what planet is the Jedi Academy at which you were trained?
Saul, don't do this.
Very well. This is the price of your resistance. Enough. You see what happens when you try to defy me.
You're a monster.
This first question was a test. Obviously, Malak knew the Academy was on Dantooine, and it has since been destroyed by our fleet.
No. You're lying.
It doesn't matter whether you believe me or not. Now, tell me your mission. How were the Jedi planning on using you to stop Lord Malak and our Sith Armada?
Screw you. I won't tell you anything.
Perhaps you need a reminder of the consequences of refusing to cooperate. Listen. Can you not hear her suffering? You can spare her further pain by simply answering my question.
Pain!
I'll kill you for what you've done. You and every Sith on this ship.
No! No! I beg you, no!
Okay, you win, Saul. We were searching for the Starforge.
Why? Why are you telling him this?
You should be grateful, Bastila. He is sparing you agony beyond comprehension. When Malak arrives, you will learn my interrogation techniques are considered merciful among the Sith. I will leave you here in your cell with a small taste of the horrors you will suffer when Lord Malak arrives.
No! Don't try to move too quickly. You might not be fully recovered yet.
That man. I'm going to kill him.
He's become some sort of sadistic monster.
First Taras, now the Academy. Is there no end to the killing?
I don't believe it. It can't be true.
I'd like to believe that Saul was lying to us. But even as he said the words, I knew they were true. The Academy is gone. I can only hope that some of the Jedi escaped. In any case, we've lost our one place of refuge in the galaxy. I only wish you'd been able to resist the Admiral's questioning. I hope the information you revealed does not bring the entire galaxy under the dominion of the Sith.
What was I supposed to do, Bastila? Just sit there and watch? Seeing you in agony like that, it tore me apart.
I appreciate your feelings for me, but you can't let your feelings override your judgment.
Bastila, you can't honestly say how you would have reacted in that situation. Nobody can. Besides, Saul already had all the information, I could tell. The interrogation was a sham. Saul was toying with us. He didn't care what we told him.
Did you feel that? A disturbance in the Force. The Admiral has sent his message. The Dark Lord knows we're here now. Malak is coming.
Well, then we better hope Juhani busts us out of here before he arrives.
Assessment. My motor functions have been impaired. You, what have you done to me, meatbag? Aggressive retort. Why, you, if my mobility center was online, I would crush your neck. Result. Mobility restored. Statement. My systems have been restored, thanks to you. Let us go rescue the Master.
Let me test this security measure. Oh, stupid primitive mechanism. Security measures bypassed.
And open the cells of our other companions. You must proceed on alone.
Well done, Juhani. In freeing us from the cell, you have proven yourself truly worthy of the title of Jedi.
Now, if I remember the layout of the ship, our equipment should be in a storage chamber just through the north doors. After we grab our stuff, we need to get to the main bridge controls. The bridge is the only place that we can open the docking gate to the hangar where they've got the Ebon Hawk.
We better get moving. I can feel the darkness of Malak's presence approaching, and I don't want to be here when he arrives.
I'm not afraid of him.
Then you are a fool. The power of the Dark Lord is strong enough to destroy any of us, even you. It would be suicide to face Malak here. We need to get away before he arrives.
Fine. Either way, we need to get to the bridge.
A small group might have a better chance of sneaking onto the bridge undetected while the others make their way down to the Ebon Hawk.
Count me in, then. I've got a score to settle with the Admiral before we get off this ship. And I have a feeling I'm going to find him on the Leviathan's bridge.
The three of us will get our equipment and make our way to the bridge. The rest of you head down to the docking hangar where they've got the Ebon Hawk. You'll have to find a way to deal with the guards.
Don't you worry about that. I know how to deal with the guards. They won't know what hit them.
All right. Stick together, everyone. I'll see you all back on the Hawk.
Just make sure the Hawk is ready to fly when we get there. And may the Force be with you.
Now, let's get going.
Thank you.
Kandaris, we've made it to the bridge. No response. I hope they're okay. Are you ready for this?
Ready.
Very resourceful. I assume you had some part in this. You learned your lessons well from me.
The only thing you taught me was betrayal and death, Saul.
Don't be a fool. I'm giving you and your companions a chance to surrender, a chance to live. Darth Malak himself is on his way. He'll be arriving any moment.
He speaks the truth, Karth. I can feel the Dark Lord's presence approaching.
Malak will destroy you. But if you throw down your weapons now, I will ask my master to be merciful.
I've seen enough of Sith mercy.
You always did like to do things the hard way. Lord Malak would have preferred live prisoners, but corpses will have to do.
Let's go! How'd you like that?
The Force fights with me! You cannot win.
Karth. Karth.
The Admiral, he's still alive.
It's time to finish this.
Make it slow.
No, Karth. Not like this. Do not give in to the hate.
Don't you understand what this man has done to my life? Do you know the pain he's brought me?
Killing him won't ease the pain, Karth. Do not become what you despise.
Karth. Must tell you. Must tell you something. Come closer. You didn't know, did you? Remember my dying words. Remember them whenever you look at those you thought were your friends.
It can't be true, can it? No, it can't. Damn you, Saul. Damn you.
Karth, what did he say?
Bastila, it is true, isn't it? And you knew. You and the whole damn Jedi Council, you knew the whole time.
Karth, it's not what you think. We had no other choice. Please, you don't understand.
So make me understand.
Guys, what are you two talking about?
Not here, Karth. Please, there's no time. Malak is coming. This isn't the place.
You are really quite astounding. You know that?
Please, Karth. I'm asking you to trust me for just a little while longer.
Look, Karth, whatever this is, Bastila's right. We need to get out of here. We can talk about this after we escape.
Okay, I'll trust you, Bastila, but as soon as we're off this ship, I expect some answers.
Of course, Karth. As soon as we get to the Ebon Hawk, I'll explain everything to both of you, I promise.
Combat mode active!
You're dead.
It was a Jedi thing too.
Never too old for this!
I will be your doom!
Let's see what you got.
Prejudice set to maximum.
Die!
Thank you.
Candorus. We're at the Ebon Hawk. Like we figured, it's under heavy guard. But don't worry. We'll figure out a plan to take care of them.
Darth Malak.
Down you go!
I hope you weren't thinking of leaving so soon, Bastila. I've spent far too much energy hunting down you and your companions to let you get away from me now. Besides, I had to see for myself if it was true. Even now, I can hardly believe my eyes. Tell me, why did the Jedi spare you? Is it vengeance you seek at this reunion?
Spare me? What are you talking about, Malak?
What? You mean you don't know? All this time and you still haven't figured it out. Even the combined power of the Jedi Council couldn't keep your true identity buried forever, could it?
The Jedi do not believe in killing their prisoners. No one deserves execution, no matter what their crimes.
The lure of the dark side is difficult to resist. I fear this quest to find the Star Forge could lead you down an all too familiar path.
They say the Force can do terrible things to a mind, can wipe away your memories and destroy your very identity.
Traditionally, the Jedi do not accept adults for training, though there are rare exceptions in the history of our order. But you are a special case.
What greater weapon is there than to turn an enemy to your cause? To use their own knowledge against them.
I sense a presence about you, Jedi. You have more power than you know.
Soon you will recognize the proper course to follow. You have matched
the correct pattern. You are deemed worthy.
Sometimes that anger, that hatred, it just feels so familiar to me. But that doesn't make it right, though, does it?
Should events come to pass, we know what we must do. We only tell him if absolutely necessary.
Become a Jedi again? That is a thing far out of reach.
Are you certain Revan is truly dead? What if we undertake to train this one and the Dark Lord should return?
It is so hard to lose your entire past. You would not understand.
Dantooine.
Tatooine.
Kashyyyk.
Manon.
Korriban.
Revan visited each of these worlds searching for clues to reveal the hidden location of the Starforge.
I wonder how long you would have stayed blind to the truth.
Revan's choices were always his own. It was not teaching or circumstance or example, it was him.
You cannot hide from what you once were, Revan. Recognize that you were once the Dark Lord. And know that I have taken your place.
This is some kind of trick.
You do not yet remember, Revan. The Jedi set a trap. They lured us into battle against a small Republic fleet. During the attack, a team of Jedi Knights boarded your ship. The Jedi strike team captured you. And the Council used the Force to reprogram your mind. They wiped away your identity and turned you against your own followers. Once I served you, Revan. But I always knew that one day the title of Dark Lord would be mine. I ordered my own ships to fire on your bridge. I thought I could destroy all my enemies with a single glorious victory.
Bastila, leave him. There isn't time.
I never dreamed the Jedi would take you alive from the wreckage. The Jedi are fools. They do not believe in executing prisoners. Originally, I assumed you had died in the battle. Imagine my surprise when I found out you were still alive, Revan.
I don't believe you. You're lying.
You must have seen flashes of your old life in your dreams, Revan. Memories bubbling up to the surface.
It's true. I was part of the team sent to capture Revan, to capture you. When Malak fired on the ship, you were badly injured. We thought you were dead. Your mind was destroyed, but I used the Force to preserve the flicker of life in your body.
But I can't remember any of this.
The Jedi Council didn't restore your wounded mind, Revan. They merely programmed it with a new identity, one loyal to the Republic. They tried to make you their slave.
Bastila, you lied to me. How many other lies have I been told by the Council?
I wanted to tell you, but the Council forbid it. They were afraid you might return to the dark side if you discovered your real identity.
But now you know the truth, Revan. The Council has failed in their attempt to make you their pawn. The will of a Sith Lord is not so easily manipulated.
I can't believe this. You're no better than Malak.
How can you say that? Malak nearly killed you, but the Jedi Council gave you another chance to live. They gave you a chance to redeem yourself by defeating the Sith.
Now fate has given me a second chance to prove myself. Once I defeat you in combat, no one will question my claim to the Sith throne. My triumph will be complete.
Triumph? You seem to forget, Malak, that I'm still alive.
The Jedi Council were foolish to let you live. I won't make the same mistake. We shall finish this alone in the ancient Sith tradition. Master versus apprentice, as it was meant to be. You are the one who taught me the ways of the Sith. The strongest must rule if we are to survive. You knew I would one day challenge you for supremacy, but you underestimated me. I acted sooner than you expected and seized the Sith throne with a single brilliant stroke. Once I served you, Revan, but I always knew that one day the title of Dark Lord would be mine. When that Jedi strike team boarded your vessel, I saw my day had come. The Jedi needed the memories buried deep in your wounded mind. There was no other way to bring them out. They had to keep you alive. They made you their puppet, Revan. And Bastila was the handler pulling your strings. You are weak. I was right to betray you. You are not fit to rule the Sith.
Weak, huh?
Statement. Our enemies have the advantage, but I have a solution.
I like the way you handled that.
Simple problems require simple solutions.
Oh, damn it.
You cannot hide, Revan. Once you were stronger than me, Revan. But as your apprentice, I surpassed you. My power is too great. Even my old master is no longer a match for me.
Yeah, maybe not. But I'll die trying.
This isn't over, Malak.
Your friends do not give up easily, Revan. You always could inspire loyalty.
For the Jedi! I'll hold Malak off. You two get out of here. Find the Starforge.
No, Bastila, he's too strong.
No!
The door's sealed. We can't get past. Come on, we have to get to the Ebon Hawk.
No, we have to help her.
Bastila doesn't stand a chance against Malak, but we can't help her. Not here. We have to get off the ship and find the Star Forge. That's the key to beating the Dark Lord.
I am not leaving her here.
Bastila sacrificed herself so we could get away. We can't let her sacrifice be in vain. Come on!
Good to see you again, Dann Kasra.
You.
This is over.
Like hell it is.
Here's what will happen. You are going to leave now, or we will execute Bastila.
You think I'm stupid? You'll kill me the second my back is turned.
Oh no, not today. You know I like a little bit of sport. Leave now, Dann Kasra, unless you want to see your friend torn in half.
Bastila.
She can't hear you.
I'll be back for you, Bastila. I promise.
A rash and futile hope.
And you, all of you, you've just made a big mistake. You'll learn why I once led the Sith.
Oh, there it is. The anger.
You're damn right it is. You wanted me angry? Fine, here it is. Darth Revan is coming for you. Bastila, I will find you. I love you.
Leave now.
Until we meet again, apprentice.
I love you too.
Where is Bastila? What happened on the ship?
We ran into Malak. He would have killed us, but Bastila sacrificed herself so we could get away.
You mean she's dead?
Bah, Malak won't kill her. Don't be foolish. He'll want to use her battle meditation against the Republic. Turn her to the dark side and the Sith will always be victorious.
This conversation is pointless. We can't help her unless we find the Starforge.
Not so fast. We've got a bigger issue to deal with here. They deserve to know the truth about you.
Karth, please. Not now.
Do you want to tell them what Malak said, or should I?
Don't piss me off, Karth. Just keep your mouth shut.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised by your attitude now that I know who you really are, Revan.
Revan? What are you talking about? Is this some kind of a joke?
No, it's no joke. The Jedi Council captured Revan and erased the Dark Lord's mind. Programming in a new identity. Saul Kareth told me on the Leviathan, and Bastila confirmed it.
You're Darth Revan? This is big. Do you remember anything about being the Dark Lord?
Just bits and pieces. Odd memories, mostly. That's it.
Just a few flashes. That's it. Nothing more? Then I don't think there's a problem. It seems to me that if you don't really remember anything about being Revan, then it doesn't really matter anymore. You are who you are now, right?
Of course it still matters. How do we know more memories won't come flooding back? How do we know Revan won't suddenly turn on us?
Do you think I asked for this, Karth? Blame the Jedi Council, not me.
Hey, you've got nothing to be sorry about. You didn't ask for this. Besides, I know you. You're not Revan anymore. Whatever you used to be, you're one of us now. Big Z and I will stick by you. We owe you our lives. We won't desert you now.
Thank you.
How can you say that, Mission? The Sith bombed my homeworld, Revan took away my family, and destroyed my life.
It was Sol Kareth who commanded the fleet that attacked your people, Karth. And it was Malak who gave the order. You know this.
You can't blame Revan for that.
I suppose you've proven yourself to be a friend of the Republic by your actions so far, Revan. But can I trust you? Can any of us?
What about the rest of you guys?
I already knew who you were, though it wasn't my place to tell you. Better off that you know, if you ask me. Does it change anything? I'm not here to judge you. You'll do what you have to do, and I'll help if I can.
You defeated the Mandalore clans in the war, Revan. You were the only one in the galaxy who could best us. Whatever you're fighting, it will be worthy of my skill. I'm your man until the end, Revan. No matter how this plays out.
Statement. Master, my loyalty to you is, as it always will be, absolute.
Well, the others seem to trust you, and I don't see any other way that we can stop the Sith. And I suppose that Malak is the real enemy here. I really don't have any other choice, do I?
I won't let you down. Any of you.
So I guess that's it then. We keep going. We've still got one more star map to uncover if we're going to find that Starforge and save Bastila, so let's do it before it's too late.
One planet left then, Korriban. I guess we should set a course. I know what's real. I'm not Darth Revan. I know who I am. I know... Oh! Damn it!
You cannot hide from what you once were, Revan. The Jedi needed the memories buried deep in your wounded mind. There was no other way to bring them out. They had to keep you alive. They made you their puppet, Revan. And Bastila was the handler pulling your strings.
You continue to be there for me, don't you? Even after I keep pushing you away, you're still around when I need you most. You're like no man I've known before. And you're nothing like what I expected you to be after the Council sent us on this mission together.